Hey, Jim Bergman here on behalf of AccuTools. Thought I'd show you some really cool stuff. We've been working pretty tirelessly on the BluVac application, made some really cool changes. So went ahead and opened up the BluVac application, and the first thing you're going to notice, updated a splash screen, but the view is dramatically changed. So we went ahead, just like measureQuick, and we made it a tabbed layout. And so you've got your home screen, you've got your grid view, you've got your gauge view, which is your primary gauge, and your toolbox. And you'll notice right away that in the toolbox, we have multiple gauges in here now. And you go, well, why would you want multiple gauges? Well, multiple gauges is actually a pretty cool thing, because what we can do with multiple gauges is we can teach people a lot of things about vacuum. In this case here, I've got a gauge at the pump. I've got a gauge at the core tool, so you know, right at the inlet, and this heads off and goes to the suction line, goes all the way through the coil, comes back out the other side, and this is 100 feet away, right, because we got 50 foot of 7/8 and 50 foot of 3/8 tubing, and this is the farthest end of the system. So if this was a condensing unit, what we'd be doing here is basically having the, this would be the liquid line, the condensing unit, this would be the suction line over here, and this would be like a typical evacuation, right? So I got three gauges hooked up here, and I'm gonna go back to the home screen. Now, the other thing we did that's really slick here is we tied this in with MQ Assist. And MQ Assist is just a way to sort of navigate you through our application, make it a lot easier to get through there. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna hit start testing, and I'll go ahead and set up the test. So when you do an evacuation, you wanna have certain targets for certain types of systems. In this case here, you can see we've got comfort cooling, new installations, we've got comfort cooling service, we've got cold climate heat pumps, and if you think about vacuum, it's really not about anything except dehydration. What we want to do is get all the moisture out that we can. We want to get the system as dry as possible. So when we're talking comfort cooling and the coil only goes down to about 40 degrees, well, it's not a big deal. We're going to get it down to maybe 1,000 microns decay rate. But if we're talking about a cold climate heat pump that could operate, you know, down with a, let's say, 15 degrees outside, negative 15, and that coil's gotta be 15 degrees colder, so we're talking negative 30. Well, then we gotta have an evacuation that's much deeper, closer to 100 microns, and with a decay no more than 200. So I'm gonna go ahead and just set this up for comfort cooling service, which is just to make it a little bit faster here. You can see also we've got a time below target, we've got a time below evac target. Time below evac target just gives us additional minutes for us to pull down and make sure the system's really dehydrated. I'm gonna change this target here. I'm just gonna go to a 10-minute decay test just to make it really easy to navigate through the app this time. Nominal tonnage here, we're gonna set this thing at 5 ton. This is a 5-ton coil, and it's got a piston type metering device on this. And then I'm gonna hit the check mark, and we're good to go. So now I'm gonna restart the evac test, and just hit yes. And I'm gonna restart my recording just so you can see what the gauges do when we come down here. So I got three gauges on the system. I'm gonna go ahead and start up the pump here. And you're gonna see right away that we're gonna go into our roughing vacuum. So the first gauge we're gonna see start to drop down will probably be our core tool, and that's only because the core tool has a pro gauge on it, which reads from atmospheric down. Our system and our pump. So now sort of everything all caught up together now, right now. But now we can also see them converging, but they're also starting to separate. So at the pump, let's go to our grid view for just a minute. At the grid view, at the pump, we're already down in the 800 micron range, 700 micron range. But you can see at the far end of the system, we're still at 2600 microns, right? And you can also see across there our ambient temperature of our gauges. You can see our evacuation rate, and you can see our saturation temperature for moisture. So now we're like at a 13 degree saturation temp on the system. At the core tool, we're at 11. And because we have a micro on here, the micro does not do the ambient temp or evacuation rate or saturation temp, we can just tell what micron range we're in. But it sort of allows us to see how deep of a vacuum we have at the pump, at the core tool, and at the far end of the system. Now, I have this set up. My primary gauge is this pro gauge up here. And the pro gauge is the farthest one on the farthest side of the system. That's where I wanna make sure I have my evacuation at my target, right? So I wanna make sure I'm at the 500 or below. Now you'll notice here, I'm gonna go back to home screen. We're only about a minute and, well, let's see, we'll just scroll across here. We are at a minute and 40 seconds in, and we just hit our top decay target of 1,000 microns. And down at the bottom here, you can see if we tap on this, you can see we're at 75 microns at the pump. So obviously there's a large discrepancy between what's at the inlet at the pump and the far end of the system. Now if you just tap off to the side here, you can get the target ranges to go away. So we're gonna let this continue to pull down. Show you a couple other things here. We have scaling, so you can turn this to linear. And linear scaling, what that does for you, allows you to see the characteristics of a vacuum. It really allows you to disseminate if you have a leak or you have moisture buildup and we're still wet on the system. We can tap linear again and it'll just sort of zoom in. Linear again, it'll zoom in even further. So as you get deeper and deeper vacuums, that linear adjustment really helps. The second here is gonna rescale. Logarithmic just takes it back to logarithmic where you see the full graph. So you got 760,000 microns all the way down to zero. And that's gonna allow us to see that. Now, the blue line now is coming up, and that's the system side, is coming up on the 500 micron target. And we're gonna see here that in just a second here, it's gonna cross, and we're gonna see the time below target indicator start to indicate. So what that does is, once we hit the evacuation target, because again, the system's still drying out, we're gonna give it a little bit more time to run below that target range. So in just a second here, it's gonna cross, and we'll start to see that time below target initiate. So that's where I just set it at 1 minute in that setting screen. And you can see it's in that final finishing vacuum. So now we're gonna let this thing run for a minute, and the next step it's gonna do, it's gonna take us through to isolate the system. But you can see here that initial degassing, if you look at the very top of the graph, everything converged really tightly together because there wasn't a lot of pressure difference between the far side of the system, the core tool and the pump, because we had all that atmospheric pressure pushing. But as we get deeper and deeper in vacuum, what's gonna happen is the lines are gonna get further and further apart until we get to a real deep vacuum, which will start to converge back together again, right? And that's when all the work sort of stops. It's the ultimate pull of the pump. But you can see right now, this large diameter hose on here, again, we're 4 minutes in, we're well below 500 microns. We're just about to our target here, and I'll show you what's gonna happen next. So once we hit our target, time below target, well, now it's time to isolate the system. So now it's gonna tell me to go ahead and isolate the system. So I'm gonna go ahead and slowly close this valve down. You wanna slowly close it because there's gas trapped in the core tool, you want the pump to grab it so it doesn't go into the system if we can. So I'm gonna slowly close that off. Then as soon as I hit continue here, you'll notice that the gauge got the signal. So the pump and the gauge, the pump and the app talk together. And you can see now what's happening is, what's cool, if you look at the blue line's continuing to drop. Let me go to the grid here for just a minute. Watch your microns on your system. Your system microns, even though it's isolated off, and I can shut this pump off here just to show this a little even further here. The pump is off and it's continuing to drop at the far side of the system because the vacuum is so deep over here. And when we get into a deep vacuum, there's not a lot of pressure left. So the pressure runs really, really slow to equalize. So you can see we have this dropping still on the far side of the system, and on the core tool side, it's slowly coming up. And that's what we call, they're converging. Now it's telling you down at the bottom here, it says wait for evacuation rate to stabilize before a decay test can start. So what we're doing right there is we're now waiting because we don't know whether you've shut the pump off or not, right? So at this point, we've told you to shut it off, but what we're watching now is that decay rate. So let's take a look here. Let's scroll through. We're still at about 19 microns, 18 microns per minute, so which means the pump's shut off, the pressures are equalizing. But in this decay test, we want to give it enough time to make sure that we don't have a leak and we're going to stay below our target evacuation. So as soon as this thing gets stabilized, which is going to take about 2 to 3 minutes to stabilize, then we're going to get our pass fail on here and we'll see the rest of our results. So we'll let this run for just a couple minutes and we'll probably scrub through the video, speed it up a little bit at this point. But as soon as this stabilizes, then we'll go to the next step. All right, so now we're down to 0 microns per minute and of rise, so we know the pump's been shut off, the system is stabilized right now, and now the app's going through and actually performing the decay test, which is doing a rise over run algorithm to look at how fast it's rising to make sure that it's not gonna hit the target before the decay time. And you can see, because it's flatlined out here, it's good to go, and we are point we're going to finish and save. So I'm going to hit finish and save right here, and I'm going to view the record here. So what I've got here is my graph showing me my total elapsed time. So literally, think about this for just a minute. We went from atmospheric pressure down to zero, performed a decay test, 7 minutes and 39 seconds total elapsed time. Final evacuation, we're at 300 microns, so we're far below our 500 micron target. Ultimate pull down was at 6 minutes 56 seconds. There's our temp. Our device is device name is a system. But now down here at the bottom, here's another cool thing. Now we're gathering our geolocation, and if I tap this again, this little QR code, it'll actually go out to a Google Map and pull in the location that the evacuation was actually performed, right? So very cool that we can see exactly where this thing was done. It'll hone in here in just a second, but we get the longitude and latitude and where the work was actually done. So now I'm gonna go back here, and let's go back, and we're gonna hit share, and we're gonna export our new Pro PDF. So again, we did a pretty nice update here, and where we've got the evacuation report, nice color report, shows the trend, shows the graph, shows the equipment makes and models. Down at the bottom has the QR code in it with the longitude and latitude. So it's pretty much everything you need to actually document an evacuation well done. And if you go back here and you want to put in things like your job information, you can put in your customer name and email address, city, state, zip, equipment models and serial numbers that'll also print out on a report. But very, very cool stuff. Allows you to really document evacuation and prove that you were there when the evacuation was done. I think this is gonna be really important for cold climate heat pumps because we're gonna have a lot of equipment manufacturers that wanna know that evacuation was done properly, and now we got great tools to do it. And combine this with the multiple gauge, again, it's really slick because you can do some neat things when it comes to either testing vacuum at multiple parts in the system, so like big VRF stuff. It's gonna be a very, very powerful tool to make sure the vacuum is done right before we put the gas into it. And big chillers or things like that where we wanna know what's the vacuum on the far side of the system. But also just for training, just to show things like I did on this and how that all works. So multiple gauge support will be a really cool feature I think you guys will like. So anyway, this is Jim Bergman on behalf of AccuTools. Hope you got a little bit out of this video, and watch for the update to come because it's gonna be out very soon.